Mario Party Superstars has a century of minigames. I spent 2 days playing every single one of them, and I found out that plenty of them are comfortable. From eating contests, to friendship building, to snowboard spinning, they always put a smile on people's faces. And playing them literally makes me want to do the exact same thing IRL. Wowie zowie! So, let's roll our dices and see which minigames are the comfiest of them all. Ah, River Raiders. Do I really need to say anything other than the fact that you get timber over treasure? Boring. This is yet another lame coin fest. The only difference now is that the scenery is even more bland, the boat controls feel super uncomfortable, and the falling hammers can give you a concussion. Ambulance, please. Ugh, a Bowser minigame. Not only is it pitch black, but you meet the gruesome fate of A, getting roasted, B, touching a spiky turtle, or C, not knowing there's an abyss and plunging right down to the bedrock. We need yet another ambulance! Now, how about we amp up the pain by adding yet another Bowser minigame? You'll endure the pain of getting impaled by a spiky ball, in addition to being kidnapped like a princess. And on top of that, it's so dang hard to dodge the rolling spikes. Man, Bowser is cruel. Spotlight Swim is basically you running from the police. And may I just say that this game is incredibly unfair? It's super easy to get caught, and on top of that, you get sent right back to the jail cell. FBI, open up! Do you like getting punched in the face? Or having a Bob-omb go kaboom in place of your birthday cake? That's what X-Ray Payday is all about, Toadsters. You can sorta prepare for what's coming beforehand, but this is Mario Party. Rushing leads to human error leads to the punch, and it all cascades from there, I guess. Bowser's Big Blast is the definition of going kaboom. All it takes is one wrong switch to ruin your entire day. The fact that this game is so RNG dependent, coupled with the boiling hot stakes of picking the wrong stick, make it so painful. What's worse is that it can even be the same color twice in a row. But does the unfairness really come off as any surprise? I mean, that's just Bowser for you, I guess. Oh look, it's yet another one of the Koopa King's discount minigames. You constantly have to be wary of the skewers coming at ya, because if they do, boy oh boy that's a trip to the hospital. And just imagine the thoughts of the person controlling the skewer. They must be having the most evil villain laugh imaginable deep down. It's Big Bertha! Did you really think that being chased by a menacing gobble-gutting fish would be comfy? I mean, you literally get turned into fresh meat for all those sharks in the water. And let's also not forget that you have to be a godlike masher to win in this game. No thanks, alligator. Dark alleyways genuinely give me the creeps. They're filled with gangsters all throughout, and what's worse is a giant bulldog attempting to gobble you up for dinner. So for your own sake, please give that chain chomp a nightlight fright. Remember that iconic Harry Potter scene with the three-headed puppy? Yeah, that's basically what Sneak and Snore is. It takes forever to get your head back into the barrel, and more often than not, I get gobbled up by the chain chomp, not to mention moving as slow as a snail. This is yet another coin minigame, and with even more hazards. Whenever you get too greedy, expect those spiky balls to get in the way. If that wasn't enough, the hungry piranha plants are constantly feasting for breakfast. And to add even more insult to injury, we all get swallowed by a freaking tornado! Guess we're all dinner now, fellas! This is by far the one Mario Party minigame I never see anyone play, and for good reason. It's at the very bottom of the minigame select, and compared to the other dual minigames, this one kinda blows. It feels so difficult to understand, and not being able to fathom it always costs me. My brain feels like mayonnaise right now, and is literally running on Patrick levels of IQ. Parasol Plummet devilishly warps your expectations. Instead of it being a floaty umbrella ride, you have to deal with falling hammers, out of control bozos getting in your way, and struggling to nab all the cash. I guess we plummeted too far, eh? Burn Style is pretty similar to a slew of Hop the Rope minigames, but it's by far the least comfy out of them all. I mean, that spiky turnstile freaking hurts. I can't tell you the amount of times I've had to carry the team on my own while playing this game, and the boiling hot lava is definitely unsettling. Dear God, Handcar Havoc comes with such blood-curdling intensity to the point where it's so easy to go too fast and fall into the boiling hot lava. That's one crispy fate if you ask me. But then again, the chaos of moving fast is kinda satisfying, and this sure is akin to a roller coaster. So... Quicksand Catch is extremely unfair and lopsided. If you're the dude in the center, expect all of your greedy friends to hog the cash for themselves. On one attempt, I got like 3 coins compared to 30 for the CPUs. How could my luck be this bad? But because the person wearing a Bowser costume looks so cool, I'll be nice and bump it up a tier. Did you really expect Goomba spotting to be anywhere else? It feels kinda boring, and on top of that, it requires a crap ton of mental processing to get the right answer. What's worse is that if you guess incorrectly, your answer is final. But the music is decent, so let's give praise where it's due. Spin Doctor is kinda lame, and pretty boring if you ask me. You just blindly walk about and deal with all sorts of gates. And if you're super unlucky, you can literally get trapped in between the pink ones. It's basically a snail race, and the reward doesn't feel super big either. Have you ever wanted to cheat in Mario Party? Well, follow these steps. Step 1. Boot up messy memory. Step 2. Take a picture of the minigame with your phone. Step 3. Wait for the curtains to close. And finally, step 4. Copy exactly what you just saw. Ta-da! Looks like your memory isn't so messy after all. In theory, Castaways would be like a jolly good adventure. There's coins, money bags, and most importantly of all, treasure. You get to fish for all the gold in the world and become bloody rich. But on the other hand, the controls are so frustrating to use, and more often than not, I get the misfortune of returning empty-handed. While it is beautiful to float around in space, Mass Meteor feels super slow, and it's incredibly annoying when you hit the floating asteroids. And I can't help but feel bad for the loser. I mean, they literally bounce around the meteors and get yeeted to infinity and beyond. Puns aside, Arch Arrival is pretty mediocre. It can be frustrating for both sides. Either you're trying to get a triple bullseye and miserably fail at the last second, or the sniper is just too OP and all three of you get KO'd in a matter of seconds. Enough said. Run for it! Petey Piranha is about to gobble me up! Oh wait, he's too slow! Better luck next time, Plant King! Manner of Escape feels pretty creepy. You keep going in circles most of the time, and the music gradually gets more intense the closer you get to the exit. Not to mention the fact that this is an RNG-based game too. Your fate is quite literally in the hands of a ghostly coin toss. Hide and Seek was one of my favorite childhood games. I remember hiding under the bed while my friends scavenged the entire house. But the problem with this minigame is that it's all a trick. The movements are an optical illusion, and your luck comes down to literal RNG. It's a minigame that's fun for the hiding trio, but annoying for the seeker. Okay, I will admit that this coin game is way more comfy compared to Puddle Paddle. Although you still have to deal with raining hammers, it's much easier to grab the coins. And on top of that, Hammer Bro is even more of a philanthropist this time around. Don't let the title deceive you. Pogo a Go-Go really means Pogo a Slow-Slow. The platform moves so slow, and so do the pogo sticks. It can be annoying trying to eliminate multiple people at once. And for the trio, falling into the infinite void is a fate of all time. Bombs Away can either be a literal cakewalk or an intense slugfest. You can bounce around on people's heads, jump up into the air, or, if you're lucky enough, emerge victorious with all your homies. But then again, because this game consists of a literal bomb shower, I wouldn't exactly call it a super comfy experience per se. Every time I play tug of war, it's the definition of intense. I kid you not, my finger literally sweats every time I rotate the joystick. You have to be perfect with your button inputs to win, and if you don't, well, say hello to the piranha plant. While many people enjoy this minigame, I find it to be kinda overrated. For one, the controls feel kinda awkward. And secondly, while popping balloons is fun, the game can be over as soon as it begins. Where's the fun if the game only lasts mere seconds? And don't get me started on playing this game online, since everyone just sits there. Rockin' Raceway is yet another minigame that seems fun on paper, but feels absolutely horrendous to control. Whenever I try playing it, I move as slow as a snail compared to everyone else, and getting the blue carrot basically means game over. However, it is still fun to ride a horse IRL, and racing people on horseback adds another level of enjoyment. So, we have to give credit where it's due. Go Goombas! Man, if only Goombella were here. But that's besides the point. While it is cool to catch Goombas, especially the little Goldies, the fact that this game is so RNG dependent kinda ruins the experience. Your fate basically rests in the hands of the Goomba gods themselves. This may be an unpopular take, but I really don't know how to win this game. Yes, it's Tetris and Candy Crush in a nutshell, and that sure is comfy alright. But what I don't like is the fact that the CPUs for this game are so outrageously difficult to beat and utilize the most unfair combo strats. Meanwhile, the max I frequently get is a +2. Next. It's time for a dungeon dash. With the fire swirling about and the thwomp squishing you and your friend like a pancake, your team's fate lies in the hands of joystick inputs. Nonetheless, it sure is fun to work together, and this game perfectly shows off the light at the end of the tunnel. Boulder Ball is fun, but man does it hurt to be squished alive by a rolling rock. Then again, the chaos of launching stuff at your friends and the triumph of being able to scale the mountain makes for a pretty okay experience, and I will say that it blows the original version out of the water too. Do you love collecting money? Well, Money Belt is the way to go. It's great getting to run on a colorful conveyor belt, and you get the chance to become rich. The only downside about this game is that it's incredibly lopsided in favor of the person at front. Barring Endless Mode, Stick and Spin is by far the longest game in Mario Party Superstars. I spent like 7 minutes straight being so locked in and matching the right marbles. But that's exactly why it's a pretty alright game to play. The music is so relaxing, the balls look so colorful, and I always feel satisfied whenever I piece them together. If I'm being honest, counting stuff is always hectic, especially since there are so many midgets to keep track of here, not to mention keeping track of bombs that explode. You really have to learn some mental math here, fellas. But nonetheless, at least you get to count some cute little toads, and for that alone, it goes up a tier.
I'm the best!
Vine with Me revolves around jumping from vine to vine and winning a race. While it is a bit on the slow side, it's still somewhat comfy to play. I mean, you basically become a big monkey for a hot minute, so there's that. Even though I love crayons, Etch and Catch is kinda disorganized. The tracing controls feel super finicky, and on top of that, me and my CPU teammate trace so sloppily. At the same time, however, we get to free the toads, and the more toads we free, the more comfy this game becomes. Not to mention that it's super easy for everyone to win. On paper, this minigame is fun. The music is so catchy, and spamming your bullet blasters makes for even more chaos. However, it feels so hard to aim the bullet bills accurately, and on top of that, you're super exposed to getting hit. When I'm in the hospital, I'm gonna have to pay off bullet bills for the doctors to treat my injuries. This is yet another ice skating minigame that has loads of great things to say about it. Running around on the ice is a great holiday treat, and racing makes it better. Despite this, I must say that the joystick controls feel so uncomfortable. I constantly find myself hitting the walls often and going awry, but who cares about any of that when you've got the little baby penguins? Aww. Whacking the pokey and competing with your friends to do it is loads of fun and makes for an interesting race. It's oddly satisfying to see the pokeballs being hammered as if this were baseball. However, if you want to be the record holder at this game, you have to become a mashing god. Coconut Conk is the definition of comic relief. The person in the barrel looks so cute and makes such a happy and goofy face. It's also really fun to roll around like that, especially IRL. And while it is kind of lopsided in favor of the trio, at least you get to pick some nutritious coconuts. Tidal Toss is the definition of lopsided, but cool. In fact, it's probably the most lopsided minigame there is. All you gotta do is spam A, release the high tide, and bam, you win. So much for surfing. It's time for goal. I remember constantly dribbling the ball and scoring. However, this game is kinda unfair for the person defending. I mean, they literally get bamboozled hard by a cluster freak of soccer balls. And for the trio team, it's basically a fun opportunity to troll your friend to the max. TikTok Hop always brings back nostalgic vibes. The clock looks very colorful, and it's basically jump rope but cooler. While it can be frustrating if you're on the inner side of the clock handle, it's still alright nonetheless. Speed hockey is so fun and hectic. The Koopa shell floating around at the speed of sound makes for crazy chaos, and hockey in general is a great winter sport. However, it's so easy to accidentally score on your own goal, and this sort of holds back its comfy potential. It's all about speed, I guess. I love eating cherries, and picking panic makes it pretty fun. Swinging back and forth is so joyful, the cherries look super tasty, and you can accumulate a crap ton of points. Quite frankly, the only panic is the thrill of cherry racing. And Woody the tree looks so smiley as always. Sure, you get squished like a pancake and squared away, but it has plenty of qualities that balance it out. For one, the 8-bit Mario square grid looks so freaking cool. Imagine playing on an 8-bit Toadette. That would have gone so hard. Secondly, it's so adorable to move around as a little square. And I can't help but notice the fact that we're literally playing at Thwomp Henge at the moment. Can you become a Dizzy Dancer? If so, this minigame is pretty alright. Despite the fact that you literally feel like a clueless puppy, grabbing the music notes feels so much fun. It's truly a competition to see who can fight their dizziness and push people around. Not to mention the fact that it literally takes place on an old-fashioned music recorder. What's the main thing you think of when it comes to war? Battle tanks, of course. Tread carefully accomplishes this by giving you the ability to pummel your friends all day long. The added pipes make the stakes better and give you more of a challenge when it comes to the tank shooting contest. Just don't tank yourself too much. Ice Rink Risk is the definition of a mixed bag. On the one hand, I absolutely love ice skating. It's so fun to do with friends, and you get to glide around like a silly little nutcracker. On the other hand, those spiny shells are super obnoxious and incredibly sharp. But if there's a risk, there's always a reward. Out of all the coin minigames, Cashapult definitely feels like it's more comfy. You get to jump high up in the sky and nab those precious little coins. While the premise remains simple, being launched into the stratosphere is way more fun than a stupid river. Man, if only they kept the nighttime setting for this minigame. Tackle Takedown lasts like 5 seconds and it's super cool. I always grin trying to run around and get away from the tacklers. This game is basically 3-on-1 tag, but with you carrying a football. Jump up in the air! Jump up, don't be scared! Jump up and your cares will soar away! Wait, what was I saying? Similarly to What Goes Up, this minigame is just as comfy. Sure, it's frustrating to slip up, but the more you concentrate, the more you can break your limits. And the higher you go, the more happy you feel. Who can possibly forget the triumph of being on top of this world? No one else could make it this far! The music on Paths of Peril is creepy, but an orchestral banger. But that's besides the point. This game brings back the satisfaction of constantly playing mobile games as a kid and finding my way through the maze. We've participated in many races so far, but Motor Rooters is the best one-on-one race of them all. Hitting the boost panels makes you go so fast, and you always feel the speed whenever that happens. And if you beat your friend, you can truly say, I am speed. If there's one thing I love doing as a kid, it's apple picking, fellas. And Honeycomb Havoc allows you to do just that, by picking ripe fruit right off the tree. Collecting all those delicious fruits actually makes my mouth water. Plus, doing this with multiple people means that you can give your friends a beating. Now you may be thinking, how in the world is Hot Rope Jump comfy? You're literally jumping over a pack of fire dudes, and if you miss, you get roasted like a chicken. Well, despite all that, I simply can't deny that I love jump roping. I did it all the time as a kid, and doing it in Mario Party is even better. It's so funny to see your friends bouncing around after touching the flames. Not to mention the endless mode enables you to break new records and adds even more satisfaction. Monty's Revenge is like whack-a-mole in reverse, but getting that obvious fact aside, seeing Peach's little head sticking out of the hole is honestly adorable. That, in addition to rushing from hole to hole, trying to avoid other people, and competing for the best time, makes for an enjoyable game. And even the Monty Moles themselves are cute. My favorite part of this entire game is when one of them gives the losers a run for their money. Shy Guy says is so much fun and is the definition of adorable. I just can't help but smile seeing the cute little guy dressed up as a pirate. The tension of raising the right flag, the beautiful sea, and the perfect rhythms all combine to make this a comfy experience. Aye aye, Captain! Have you ever tried bouncing balls as a kid? If so, Bumper Balls is the place for you. It's so much fun bumping your friends off the edge, and the different terrain makes it even better. What's more, you can do it at either the top of Mount Everest or on a Minecraft grass block. Looks like we're in the ball game now. Mecha Marathon is all about being a good masher and winding up that fly guy. Seeing those cute little critters fly off is so adorable, I swear. They remind me of one big animal pack and how they always stick together. Not to mention the usual shenanigans of setting new records and pressing buttons for the win. I loved playing mini golf as a kid. I constantly remember doing it with my grandpa, and I even got a hole in one. Chip Shot Challenge is exactly the type of thing golf enthusiasts need. And whenever I play it, I still feel the satisfaction of getting a perfect hole. It's Mario Golf time, baby! In real life, ice hockey is a peak winter sport, and for good reason. You get to team up with cool lads, you get to skate all over the pretty terrain, and of course, score some goals. You truly feel a sense of pride whenever you hit a power shot. If not for the 1 minute time limit, this game would be a lot more comfy. Happy birthday to you! It's time to make a cake at the Cake Factory. Those cakes look so delish, and the race couldn't be more enjoyable. I mean, it's basically two dumb chefs up against another pair of dummy chefs. Also, the conveyor belt moving faster, the scramble to get cakes, it's the best birthday cake ever! Guess you could call that a mouthful? Shell soccer is basically goal, but way, way more comfy. Aiming for each Goomba feels so rewarding, and the constant back and forths can even prolong the game, and the longer it goes on, the more fun and chaos there is to behold. This game basically combines both bowling and soccer into one, and I'm all for it. Also, can we give a salute for how freaking awesome this music is? One of the most memorable experiences of my childhood was becoming Godzilla and destroying everything in Super Mario Bros. The Mush Pit offers exactly that with the good old Mega Mushroom. You get to feel the thrill of being big and knocking your friends out of the house. And I mean, who wouldn't find Giantess Peach to be hot?
FBI, open up!
Tube It or Lose It is so much fun! You get to tube down the mountain like in Sonic Adventure, glide off the ramps, and basically play tubing tag while you're at it. While it is sort of easy for the solo player to eliminate the trio, that makes for even more funny reactions. Bouncy balls are perfect for stress relief. The fact that you all get to bounce and trounce each other is so adorable. It makes me feel like I'm at some kind of circus. I can't help but laugh whenever I spin like a helicopter and knock someone off. Do you like having a pet plant? Well, Storm Chasers makes it even more fun by seeing who can water their piranha plant the fastest. It's such a thrill to run around and get the cloud. It's kinda like you and the fans trying to meet your favorite celebrity, or being first in line to buy Mario Party Jamboree. And just look at how these little critters grow up so fast. Aww. Slot Car Derby is Mario Kart in a nutshell. The thrill of moving around at the speed of sound is pretty self-explanatory. Although it's easy to speed out of control, racing against your friends and achieving new records still make it great. The stages also have quirks here and there. They have more slopes, more curves, and more opportunities to have fun. Although this game constantly explodes in your face, Reverse-A-Bomb is super fun to play. The bob-ombs look kinda adorable, and everything going kaboom makes you feel so powerful. Not to mention the colorful aesthetics, and the music adding on to the adrenaline. Do I even need to explain how funny Facelift is? It's one thing to hear Bowser's weird sense of humor in the RPGs, but seeing his goofy little face is even better. It's hilarious to recreate his amazing facial expressions, and if you get it all correctly, you feel like an accomplished artist. Man, Bowser, you'd be a great stand-up comedian! And speaking of faces, Look Away does it even better. The music is jazzy and chilly, you get to dance, and look at everyone's cute little faces. Aw, they're just too precious! Also, there's something really funny about the trio getting super angry. LMAO. Balloon Burst makes popping balloons a lot of fun. The big Bowser balloon looks so adorable and chubby, and all you gotta do is pump it up with your friend. Mom, can I get a Toadette balloon, please? High up in the sky! God, I will never stop saying this, will I? Anyways, Sky Pilots is absolutely a fun fest. First, the party music brings me back to the good old days. And second, the team building is so much fun. Flying through the air, boosting through the rings, oh boy, this game totally deserves sky-high ratings. If there's one thing you can do to impress the girls, it's playing beach volleyball. Playing this sport IRL is such a joy, and it perfectly carries over to Mario Party Superstars. You can go for amazing sniper shots, passes, and allow teamwork to make the dream work. There's a reason why it's one of my favorite title screens, Toadsters. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells run. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Whee! Did someone say even more teamwork? Dungeon Duos blows Dungeon Dash out of the water. It's so fun getting to see the wholesome dynamic between you and your friend, with loads of fun and intricate puzzles to solve. It's the perfect way to test your big brain IQ and friendship skills. But the best part about it all is pumping the hot air balloon and going high up in the sky! Catch you later! First off, the Shy Guy Mailman looks really cute, especially when he runs around. And competing to see who can give him the most love letters is perfect for Valentine's Day. This game really makes you dig up all the treasure on the ground, am I right? Rapid River Race breaks your pace. At the start, everyone looks so happy and ready for adventure. I always have the time of my life going at max speed on the water. It heavily reminds me of jet skiing and all sorts of aquatic racing games, and the triumph you feel from speeding so fast and getting first feels like you're on the top of the world. Holy crap, Toadsters! That's a whole lot of penguins! Jokes aside, seeing the little Piplups is the definition of adorable. Additionally, the franticness of trying to stay on top, running around, and listening to amazing music is also incredible. Man, I wish you could have a pet penguin, it would be so cute! And who can possibly forget the part where all the penguins literally dance when you win? Tipsy Turny is known for solving mysteries and bringing out the fun. Rolling the shell and uncovering the panels feels so satisfying. Every time I reveal that cheeky little star, I always let out a celebratory smile. Paint Misbehavin' is basically Splatoon in a nutshell, and oh boy, this minigame is so much fun! Hitting all of the Goombas with paint makes them look so goofy and colorful, and you feel like a pro artist when getting them all at once. Oh, and the fact that the winners shoot paint at the losers will never not crack me up, LMAO. Do you like pushing your friends into the infinite void? Well, the final countdown is just for you. Seeing the numbers count down feels oddly satisfying, no pun intended, and the adrenaline this game has to offer feels unreal. Rocky Road is teamwork makes the dream work. It feels so crunchy to break all the bricks with your teammate, and on top of that, you get to have a fancy car ride with Toad. It's an amazing race all the way through, and what would have made it better is licking some Rocky Road ice cream. But the comfiest part about this minigame? Getting to ride in the drippy limousine with both Toad and Toadette. Oh my god, the cuteness is too much! It's time for Major League Baseball, ya champs. I always have a blast hitting the baseballs and competing with my friends. It ignites my athletic spark and motivates me to push towards victory. I also can't forget how the music makes the competition even more wacky. Also, the Goombas, Koopas, and Shy Guys cheering in the background are so cute. Home run! Do you love snowboarding? Well, Snow World is the place to go. Spinning on your snowboard and doing all kinds of tricks makes you feel like a complete Chad. Although I'm more of a skier myself, I can't deny that snowboarding is the epitome of fun winter sports. Booksquirm has so much comfy stuff to offer. The endless book, the colorful pages, amazing shapes. Who wouldn't like this game? It's so enjoyable to run from hole to hole with your friends and come out as the last man standing. And the endless mode gives you even more of a fun challenge. Guess you could call yourself a bookworm. It's pizza time. Although I'm not the biggest fan of mashing, I can't deny that Eats a Pizza is fantastico. The toppings, crust, the cheese, everything is so delish! My mouth literally drools every time I gobble up the pepperoni in-game, and puts me right in the mood for a Domino's pizza delivery. And becoming the best pizza bros is the cherry on top. Crazy Cutters is archaeology on steroids. You get to cut a literal fossil, which can be a ghost, dog, or blooper. Cutting it perfectly with the jackhammer feels so satisfying, and the higher you score, the more accomplished you feel. I could do this again and again and always improve. Not to mention the fact that you literally free them from extinction. Flash Forward is so chaotic, yet is filled with smiles and rainbows. You can jump, shove your friends around, and most importantly, pose for the camera. And the photos Toad takes are so funny and hilarious. I mean, what did Daisy ever do to you, Peach? And what an awkward stare, Birdo. Everyone, say cheese! Coney Island is the definition of ice cream heaven. It's so much fun to compete with your friends and build the biggest ice cream tower of all. Man, I would definitely gobble up cookies and cream any day of the week. Oh, and this minigame is also named after one of my favorite streamtubers. All hail Coney! Trace Race is all about being neat and being a good drawer. It's so fun to trace the path perfectly, and the artistic scenery makes everything so colorful. Man, just playing this game makes me wish I was back in elementary school art class, the good old days of drawing with crayons. Oh. My. God. Mushroom Mix-Up is so freaking comfy, alright? Being able to squish your opponents and jump on their heads is a great way to provoke the funniest reactions, and jumping from mushroom to mushroom truly makes you a superstar. That, and seeing Toad as a cheerful referee makes it even better. I could do this for hours and hours on end and never get tired of it. There is a reason why this is the most iconic minigame in Mario Party history, fellas. And finally, the comfiest game out of them all is none other than... Snowball Summit. This is hands down my favorite minigame in all of Superstars, and there's plenty of reasons why. For one, it's snowing! And secondly, playing snowballs and playing with your friends during the winter is a fantasy I've always loved. We've had plenty of winter-based minigames, but this is quite literally a frosty festival. The cherry on top is rolling the big snowballs and hearing everyone scream like a high-pitched girl. Oh man, this game is just too comfy in every sense of the word, and without further ado, it's time to sing a little Christmas carol. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow! Well, that was quite the journey. 100 comfy minigames later, and I'm so ready to jump right into Jamboree. Because, oh man, just look at it! We get a cute little ninja, singer chick Pauline, and most importantly, Toad and Toadette are back, baby! Yahoo! It's shaping up to be the best Mario Party game ever, and more fun means more comfort. See you later, Toadsters!